First off, I want to give all praises and glory to the Most High Yahweh in the name of His only begotten Son, Yahweh Shai. Double honors unto the elders and apostles of GMS who taught me this truth. Salutations to all the brothers that's pushing this word in truth and sincerity, in peace, blessings, and healings unto the elect. And today, I got a couple of videos I want to get out to the people because there's a lot of protests going on in Ohio, Michigan, South Carolina, North Carolina. So, you know, let's get started. And then after I play these videos, I'll get some scriptures. So this is the one in Michigan. So let's load it up. So that's all I'm going to get of that one. That's in Michigan, at the Michigan Capitol, because the governor extended the lockdown, I think, to May something. So that's all I'm going to get of that one. Yeah. I ain't trying to watch that shit. But this is Operation Gridlock. I think this is in the same place. I'm not sure. Lansing, Michigan. So let's see.
I was laying in bed, tripping, just really bummed out about what was happening and praying, and God just kind of put on my heart, go up to Lansing, make a physical presence.
Anthony DiMaggio is a small business owner who worked with the Michigan Conservative Coalition to make this protest, known as Operation Gridlock, a reality. Thousands of people came to the state capitol to protest Governor Gretchen Whitmer's Stay Home, Stay Safe executive order. DiMaggio says Whitmer's actions have left a lot of people just like him out of work.
We've had enough. So we're practicing what you see is our right to express our heartfelt feelings. We want to get back to work.
And other people we talked to who attended today's rally tell us it's time for all of Michigan to get back to work, not just so-called essential workers. After all, they say, everyone needs a paycheck.
The people of Michigan will not put up with their rights taken away.
Bills don't stop, you know. My credit is good, and I want to keep it that way.
If I don't make money, my family doesn't eat.
And as you can imagine, these protesters want Whitmer to get the message.
We all just want to work, and it's just about time that, for whatever reason, Governor Whitmer isn't getting it. It's time to get it.
Reporting in Lansing, James Felton, TV5.
You know, I want to say something, bro. Listen. They did the same model in China. So they shut down in China. They shut down Wuhan and the surrounding cities, I think, in January. Right? And then everything didn't get back to normal until April, the beginning of April. So they're going to run the same model over here. It took 4 months for them Moabites to crack. And obviously you Edomites can't take how long this shit been locked down? 2 months maybe? And y'all already begging. Y'all going to be begging for the vaccine to get back to normalcy. And y'all gonna be begging for the chip when it come out. You know what I'm saying? So it is what it is, but this is in Ohio. This is in North Carolina.
Protests over the state's stay-at-home order in downtown Raleigh today, despite the ban on mass gatherings. CBS 17's Capitol reporter posted this on social media today, and it's been viewed more than 100,000 times. One woman arrested after protesters gathered in downtown Raleigh demanding the governor reopen North Carolina. The protesters are a part of a group called Reopen NC. And tonight, CBS 17's Maggie Newland is digging deeper into what that group is all about.
Despite a ban on gathering, 100 people came together in downtown Raleigh demanding the governor reopen the state.
Enough is enough. You know, this has definitely gone on long enough.
Ashley Smith's a co-founder of the private Facebook group #ReopenNC. She says she and two others created the group after hearing it was possible the governor could extend the stay-at-home order past the end of April. The group has more than 30,000 members. Many are worried small businesses won't survive the shutdown. During the protest, some people stayed in their cars, others gathered outside. Police initially told them to stay 6 feet apart.
You are in violation of the executive order.
And ultimately told people to leave. Raleigh police posted on social media that protesting is a, quote, non-essential activity and violates the governor's order. Capitol Police arrested a woman. She's charged with violation of an executive order.
These officers are just doing their job, and I'm just doing mine.
The group says this is all about people going back to their jobs.
If I have exactly what I want right now, I would ask the governor to get out of North Carolina's way and let us go back to work.
But state leaders say that could have dangerous consequences.
Our efforts to stay at home are working. It is slowing the spread.
These models show consistently that our executive orders work, and that wholesale lifting of those orders would be a catastrophe.
That was Maggie Newland reporting. Raleigh police said the group did not need a permit and could protest. We reached out to Raleigh police late tonight, but we have not heard back.
So, this is only the beginning of the protest because, you know, the economy crashed, bro. So where y'all going to, them 20 million people that's unemployed, where y'all going to go back to work to? Donald Trump gonna send y'all $1,200. That shit gonna run out in what? A month, maybe? Less? If you got a family. 2 weeks? Yeah, so these protests, this is only the beginning. We're at the beginning of sorrows and it is what it is. But I'm going to get some scriptures. This is 2 Ezra chapter 9. I'm going to start at the top. He answered me then and said, measure thou the time diligently in itself, and when thou seest part of the signs pass, which I have told thee before, then shalt thou understand that it is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world which he made. Therefore, when there shall be seen earthquakes and uproars of the people in the world, and you know, these are uproars, those videos I just played, you know, it's only the beginning of the uproars of the people, because you had uproars of the people, protests all over the world, in China, down there in South America, you had the yellow vest protesters. Yeah. But the apostles and elders of GMS on down been saying when that shit hit America, you know we in the end. So when y'all Americans go out there and protest at big numbers like in Occupy Wall Street, you know, it's the end of things. Because 20 million people out of work, y'all not going back to work. The economy crashed. It's not bouncing back. Point blank, period. I'm going to start at 4. Then shalt thou well understand that the Most High spake of those things from the days that were before thee, even from the beginning. So Yahweh Shemashah told us that all this was going to happen from the beginning. For like, as all that is made in the world have a beginning and an end, and the end is manifest. So the end is manifest because America's on lockdown. The whole world's on lockdown, and they're bringing in their new world order. Can't be refuted if you know what's going on. Even so, the times also are the highest at plain beginnings and wonder and powerful works and endings and effects and signs. So the effects and signs are uproars of the people and earthquakes, as it said in 3. And everyone that shall be saved and shall be able to escape by his works and by faith whereby ye have believed. So if you believed on Yahweh Shemashah, if you you know, did your works, you had faith and you believed, a combination of the 3, you know, you got a good chance of escaping the perils that's coming. Shall be preserved from the said perils, and shall see my salvation in my land and within my borders, for I have sanctified them for me from the beginning. So that's self-explanatory. If you believe, you was meant to believe from the beginning. If you didn't believe, you wasn't meant to believe, you know, and that's just how Yahweh Shemashah rose. But this is 2 Ezra 15 and 16. For there shall be sedition among men. And you know that's sedition. And invading one another, they shall not regard their kings nor princes, and the course of their actions shall stand in their power. Now they shall not regard their kings nor princes. They shall not regard their governors for making that executive order. So they're out there protesting it. And what it is saying in that video, that protesting is non-essential, so you can get arrested. So you Edomites out there, them Rothschilds, them Gettys, them DuPonts, them Clintons, them Bushes, they don't care about you. So if you want to get your country back, you're going to have to fight for it. You know, but the Israelites, the ones that's been pushing this, because we knew this was going to happen. We're just going to get the popcorn, sit back, and watch y'all go crazy out there. We ain't going to do nothing. We ain't going to fight. We ain't doing nothing. We're just going to sit back and keep doing what we've been doing. But, you know, I think I got the points of what I wanted to get. You know, it's a short video, but, you know, more to come. I'll make a video tomorrow. But, double honors to the elders and apostles of GMS, you know, who taught me this truth and call halal Yahweh by Hashem, Yahweh Shah, by Hashem, Rahach Kodash.